gas in the airplane bathroom right now. We're about to be on our way to Paris.
Fashion week.
I don't want people to hear me talk to myself. I need like a cute outfit right now. I'm gonna change into sweats before our next like 6 hours. Like, arrived at the Airbnb.
About to go to the shit on the corner. Yeah,
Grumman's is here. I'm just
gonna... This is the littlest Airbnb I ever been. Yeah. You see this
she's
shit?
Small as fuck. She's small, but you know, she's humble. This?
Cheesecake? Yo, bro, this is what kind of cheesecake is this? This is what the fuck? Do this even look like American cheesecake?
That is not cheesecake.
It is. It said it. That's why I got it. I was like, yo, I'm in Paris. This shit probably be fire. It's cool, but it ain't like American.
What does it taste like?
It's cool, but.
That's not cheesecake.
That's what I'm saying.
That's good.
This is my ride. Man, it was cheap as hell.
So, yeah, I'm gonna go get a little coffee at the bakery that's like right next to us. And then I'll be back. Good morning.
Yo, I'm tired as fuck.
Oh, you sound fucked.
This nigga Yoshi had mad weed left over here trying to get to me. I fucking fell asleep.
Where?
His flight was at 8 a.m.
So there's no weed?
He gave me a little bit, but like, I was in the spot. Just put it in, but he's like, nah, bro, just save your money. Like, I'm about to, like, niggas gotta get moving, like, right now.
Morning eats espresso double, deux sucres parce que triple chocolat. C'est ça? Est-ce que c'est bon? You just sit. I'm gonna move it. So today, the men are trying to go to shows that we're not invited to. So we may do that. And then I have a showroom thing at like 5:36. And then Jessica's gonna be here, so we're gonna go to dinner. That's the plan right now. Might completely change. Okay. We're getting ready. This is what I have right now going on.
Bitch, me right now, she ain't know. I came up from Bond.
Okay. Lil.
I said I came up from Bond, she ain't know.
Lil latex shorts from Next Latex. These tights from.
Next Latex.
From. You know that really good brand? My tabbies. This top that I thrifted, and this Ralph Lauren blazer. Like, it's because we don't have a fucking full length mirror here, so I actually don't know if this looks bad. And then I'll probably just do this vibe because I have shit to bring. I was trying to like get inspo from Givenchy, but I don't know, they're kind of all over the place.
Cellini.
We're going to the pop-up.
What pop-up?
Yeah, I don't know what brand
this is. It's some dude named Codone. I don't know. I don't know them like that, but like I know people that be with them, you feel me? And Jared is also doing like a free giveaway there.
He keeps saying Jared and I have no idea who he is.
He's the nigga that be like, what you wearing? You know, there's a lot of niggas.
There's like 70 of those.
Yeah, there is, but like
LA, what are you wearing today?
Yeah, he's from LA.
Alright, so we're gonna go to that. And then we'll catch you later. Guys, bad news. I already found a vintage store. Look at these. Those are so cute. I actually need to get out of here. Guys, stop this. We got some fast food, turned out to be a gourmet ass meal. Look at this. Oh, nice plate, nice carafe d'eau, like, hello? $10. Shook. Now it's time for the taste test. Stop doing that and I won't cut it out.
What did I do? What are you talking about? Niggas could have gave me that.
The fact that you just got a burger and no fries is crazy.
Well, it's because I'm going to steal both of yours.
Show you. No.
Yeah.
Maybe, but got.
No. No, you stole my hand yesterday. You good, my heart.
You just stole my fucking bowl. With the
Fucking made it. We had a treacherous bike ride.
It was kind of a movie though.
It was a movie. Low-key, we almost got run over 6 times. But yeah, we're about to go into the showroom and see the new collection. Do I even know of what brand?
What?
She brought me. We don't even know what's happening.
Did you see? Second floor, yeah.
Okay. There's a code. See you in there.
Updates, guys. I had a treacherous time. I fell off my bike. Guys, we fucking were biking here. I fell off my bike because you know there's a little side road thing. The side of my tire kind of against it. Bam, bike goes on the fucking floor. And you know those fucking damn electric bikes are heavy as hell. So I couldn't even like humbly like kind of fall off it and hold the bike. The bike was out. It fucking skips out of my hands. I'm like, and we're in front of like a full restaurant of people sitting outside. And they're like, oh, everyone goes, oh. Which I wanted to kill myself. I wanted to end it all. We have a little damage here. Embarrassing. But it's okay because now we have drinks. Drinks that really just are solving everything. We were supposed to go to a party or something, but we need a drink, we need a little food. So we're waiting for
some bread.
2 miles in. Jessica, who is coming from London. So hey, I haven't seen her in like fucking ages since she moved out of New York, so we're hyped. We got the little camembert avec le miel, avec le thyme. We're about to eat this shit up. Give us a taste test.
Okay, I'm gonna push bread this time. Let's just. Should I just dip bread?
Yeah, I'm gonna dip it.
I'm gonna just dip it in. Oh, nice.
Oh no. Yeah.
I'm gonna get some of this. Okay, ready?
Oh, look at that. Stunning. It's good. Oh my god, guys, it's fucking Jessica. Did you think you would ever see her on the YouTube? I thought maybe never again. Who knew? We got our foods. Mine low-key looks like dog food, but that's just the way it is. Got a little Saint-Germain.
The weed was gone, so
we walked. Oh, look, let me tell you a fucking story, yeah? Doctor over here. We gotta go get the eight. It's in the post box. In the post box. Like, fuck it, okay. We're waiting for 10. Let's go get the weed. We show up, he like punches in the code of the Airbnb, open the thing, there's nothing inside. It's just fucking cobwebs. Shit.
So you know what we did? We opened up every single one. Not only we didn't stop there, we started sniffing around.
Sniffing.
Get some mildew, some evidence to scroll up. Nothing.
So y'all come back empty-handed.
Well, no, because in the end I had to do it.
Yeah, just didn't push.
Would have had
We're ending the night where all people should end their night in France.
La fucking boulangerie. La fucking boulangerie. Je comprends pas comment c'est ouvert à cette heure. Mais je me suis pris un petit croissant, je me suis pris un petit sandwich. Et ouais, on aime ça, on aime ça. Mais regarde tout ce qu'il y a et il est 1h du mat. Right there. Check tout ce qu'il y a ici, ici, ici. Genre je me demande si je prends ça aussi en même temps. Genre, good morning.
The only way I justify punching a bitch in the face is if she you will get a hate crime.
It's the morning, day two. I have a little shoot. I'm meeting up with my friends. I'm my sister's friend, who's like a photographer, videographer. We're gonna do a little video shoot. Yeah, let's go. So it's fine. Okay, so I'm in the middle of the shoot right now. It's going good. We just filmed in this look with this big skirt. And now I'm gonna change into my hooded YSL dress. The people in this cafe, we're in a cafe right now. The people in this cafe are about to be like, oh, this bitch just outfit changed. Where did she pull this shit out of? But, gotta do what you gotta do. Gotta do what you gotta do.
What about this?
Hey, chicken loose. Oh, you're gonna die.
How?
What do you mean how?
So no to these?
You can wear them if you want to like suffocate, but.
Is it even hot though?
Yes.
What are they sending TikTok season?
Okay, I just got ready. I'm actually locking on the vlog, but it's because I've just been doing the same thing all day, so I was not trying to bore you guys with our little video shoot, but basically it was like a short film type of thing that we shot. We went to the Louvre, we went, shot in her apartment, shot on the streets. It was cute. Now we're gonna go to some Italian restaurant, meet Jessica.
That's OD.
And then hopefully go to a jazz bar. And also look at my knees from falling off my fucking bike yesterday. Yeah, looks like yeah. Anyways, we're gonna go to a jazz bar later. And also a photo booth. See you guys later! Ooh.
Speechless.
I'm so excited. Dude, I'm so excited. Just got to my little jazz bar.
I can't wait. Living my La La Land dream.
First time?
Mm-hmm. I'm so excited.
Bringing everyone I know here.
This is like a dream.
I'm probably gonna bring in my camera for like 2 minutes and then check it. Because it's a good time in there. I'll get a couple clips for you though. Okay. J'ai trouvé une petite. Ah! Non, mais. Ah!
Oui, non, oui.
Non, mais ça, c'est des crêpes, ça, c'est des gyros. Crêpes, on va rate les crêpes. Ok, taste test all the crêpes, post club crêpes.
No, stand up, I can't work.
This is amazing.
This is amazing.
No, like this is.
This is.
It's not like a shitty grape. This is amazing.
It was €4.
Damn,
brother. Mhm. America could never.
Imagine. That's what I was about to say. Imagine this would be like your munchies the whole time. After the club regularly.
Are you kidding? Mm. There's a place on Ludlow that sells grapes. Post club, that's where we are, like $14.
Did anybody get a banana?
I want to get a BBL and a goddamn lip filler.
Me too.
Those are great British frowns.
Oh, crazy.
You think they'll notice?
Look at this. Stunning. Merci. Good morning. Look who it is.
Hello.
It's my little chicken, Jessica. This fine morning, I came to Jessica's hotel room because look how cute her bathroom is. Yeah. Way cuter than fucking mine. And I had to record, literally, I just trusted. I had to record a brand deal this morning, so, and it was for skincare brand, so I needed a cute bathroom, and I was not about to film it in our busted ass white Walmart ass lighting bathroom. But today, this is my outfit. We are going to Montmartre to have breakfast and kind of spend the day there. Yeah, I'm excited.
Les parois de ma vie sont lisses. Je m'y accroche, mais je glisse.
We are now walking around Montmartre. It's so pretty here. It feels like a little cute town. We're going to find this photo booth that we saw online. We just went to the photo booth. These are the pickies.
Mine was a test, but I think it's cute still.
And then right now we're just sitting here. Oh my god, this is the spot! This is the spot!
No, it's not.
This is the spot. So guys, this random skincare brand texted me this morning on DM me and was like, hey, we are a skincare brand, we have locations in Israel and Monaco and Paris. We want to gift you some products. And I was like, okay, cool, well I'm actually in Paris, so I can just come, you know? And they were like, okay, bet. So I go, thinking I'm just going to get products. This woman puts me in a full facial treatment. I'm like, oh, yeah. I was not expecting this. And then gave me some products. So I'm pretty hyped about it. A little free facial, what the fuck? We're going to a vintage shopping appointment. Had to do it to him, even though we have less than enough space in our suitcase. What are we gonna do about that? Shopping appointment, guys. Yeah. Look at the pieces we're trying on. This Versace top, are you fucking kidding? Custom. And these two beautiful dresses. Yeah, of course. And we just have this whole room to try on.
Yeah.
Okay guys, I just got home and changed into this outfit for the night from Jaden. I wanna open the skincare I got gifted from Christina. The facial was fire, and I'm pretty sure they gave me the steps that they used. Tonight we're going to, I think it's a Lebanese restaurant that Jessica found, which I'm hyped about because I fucking love Lebanese food. It's both Jessica and Miles' last night in Paris, so we're all going out together. Okay, first we have this illuminating gommage, which is a mask. I've also been getting more and more into skincare recently, probably because I've been really breaking out, so you can't see it because I put a little bit of concealer on. But I just want my skin to be perfect. Beauty mask. Basically, when I got to the facial, they had me complete a whole big document about my skin and all my concerns and da 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 da.
And then they assign you like a treatment. I think they have like 12 treatments or something. They assigned me the Muse treatment. This is the Muse Supreme Serum. How gorgeous is this? So excited to put these in use. Anyways, let's go!
Guys, we're not in Montreal. This is not Bustan, but it's all Bustan, so it's close enough. We'll see. We'll see how it compares.
Guys,
announcement.
We've just found the best Lebanese restaurant in Paris. It's called Alphonse, and we're in the second arrondissement. 10 out of 10, and I don't give 10 out 10s easily.
10 out of 10, like
I'm a picky fucking like, eater.
Close to Bustan, and you know that means a lot to me. So hold up.
Now, boy, do I have a story for you. Boy, do I have a fucking story for you. I'm not gonna lie, I'm fuming. I'm not gonna lie, I'm fucking fuming right now. So, let me set the scene. We're on the Seine. We're walking from the restaurant that we had bomb food at. We're going to Pamela, where we're supposed to meet our two guy friends, me and Jess. We're walking, we're literally like 3 minutes away. We get to the end of the Seine, we're turning the corner. I'm standing there waiting to cross the street with my phone in my hand, kind of just like this, looking at my Google map, making sure we're going the right way. This guy passes behind me. I kind of see him and I'm like, oh, okay, whatever. I keep looking at my phone. The next thing I know, this guy walks past me, grabs my phone out of my hand and sprints off with my fucking phone. I literally was like, I was in shock. Like I was in shock. I didn't know what to do. I was not about to run. I had 7-inch heels on. There's no way I would have won that fight, you know? Like it was not about to happen. I obviously just started having a panic attack because that's what I do. And Jessica's like, what the fuck? I'm like, Jessica, you have my location. She's like, no, I actually don't. For some reason, Jessica doesn't have my fucking location. I don't know how. I thought she did. So we're trying to call the guys because I know that one of them has my location. They're not answering for the life of them. For like an hour, they're not answering their phones, which is super awesome and super nice of them, I know. So I call Colin, the little angel he is. And he has my location, so he's sending me live updates of where the phone is every 3 seconds, like. And the people around me, like two people saw, and were like, you need to call the cops. And I'm like, from my experience, I'm like, the cops are not gonna help. Like, cops in New York, they're not gonna help you find your stolen phone. And last time this actually happened to me, I got my phone pickpocketed in Miami. In Miami, when it happened to me, the cops like barely helped. Like they honestly really didn't give a fuck. So I was like, they won't give a fuck. It's gonna be a waste of my time. Finally, we're like, okay, honestly, like we have a location right now. We should do it. We call the cops. They come to us and they're like super serious. And I'm like, oh, these people are actually gonna try to help. We get into the car. They're like, okay, you guys have the live location? I'm like, yeah. They're like, okay, get in the car. We start literally like this fucking driver like thinks he's in GTA. Like I swear to God, this guy is going fast and furious. Like he's like the fucking meow 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 fucking swerving in them lanes like ra 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 cutting people off. I'm like, I literally thought I was gonna die. Like me and Jess were in the back like, what the actual fuck, we're actually gonna die. He was doing the most, but like in a great way. At some point, we're trying to look. We obviously can't fucking find him. I barely saw the guy. Like, he just zoomed past me. I barely know what he looks like. Whatever, we're in the car with these fucking policemen for, like, 1.5 hour. Like, 1.5 hours. We couldn't find him. And then we get to the club where the men are still at the fucking club. Like, our guy friends are still at the fucking club. While we're literally in distress, like, I'm literally gonna die. And Jessica's flight
meanwhile, is in 4 hours. Like, Jessica has not packed a single thing. Her flight is in 4 hours. I'm like, okay, Jessica needs to leave. I just got my phone stolen and I have no way, we have no way of getting home because Jessica has no more money on her card because, so we're basically stranded and these guys won't get out of the club. They're like, if we get out of the club, they won't let us back in. I'm like, is this our biggest problem right now that you won't get back into the club? Oh my God, I'm honestly just like fuming. We had to literally beg them to come help us. I was like, this is insane. Like, me, if a friend or honestly anyone is unsafe, got their phone stolen and needs like help, I'm there with no questions asked. My night is over. I'm there and I'm helping you. Like, I don't know. The fact that other people don't think that way is kind of wild to me. But I guess to each their own. I need to go get a new phone tomorrow. So I don't know how I'm gonna get to the Apple store with no phone, but we'll see. Wish me luck.
Editing Ed here to fill you in because I was so in distress this day and I was not updating y'all. Basically, I went to the Apple store, I ordered myself a fucking Uber from my iPad, got in the Uber, and went to the fucking Apple store. At the Apple store, I was sure. Like, I was pissed that I got my phone stolen, but I was like, at least I know that I have theft and loss protection, because last time I got my phone stolen in Miami, when I went to buy a new phone, I remember vividly the guy being like, so obviously you're gonna put theft and loss protection on this phone, right? And I was like, yes. And I remember saying I wanted the theft and loss protection. So I was like, hey, it's fine. I'm gonna get a free new phone. Like, it's chill. I get to the Apple store and he's like, well, even if you have theft and loss protection, we're gonna need to ship in a phone from the US. And it's gonna take like 4 days because the phones in France are different than the ones in the US. I'm like, I just start fucking bawling my eyes out in this Apple store. The Apple employee is like, this is so awkward. Like, he's just like, so do you wanna buy a new one? No, I don't wanna fucking buy a new one! I thought, okay, nonetheless, I still have the protection and I'll get a new phone in when I'm back in New York. For now, I'm just gonna struggle and die without a phone, I guess. But it turns out when I actually came back to New York, I went to the Apple store and I actually didn't have the Apple Care. I don't know who's at my door. So yeah, the guy tells me, yeah, actually, you don't have Apple Care for theft and loss. And I'm like, that's impossible. That's literally impossible. You have to have made a mistake. And he's like, no, you don't have it. There's no receipt of you ever having it. And I was literally, again, bawling my eyes out. I had to pay myself a fucking new phone. It was like $2,000. I swear to God. Anyways, so what ended up happening was, after having a mental breakdown in the Apple store, I texted my friend Valeria from my iPad and I was like, can I spend the day with you? I don't have a phone. And she said yes. So we went to a flea market and this is how it went.
Les parois de ma vie s'enlisent. Je m'y accroche, mais je glisse lentement vers ma destinée. Mourir d'aimer, tandis que le monde me juge. Je ne vois pour moi qu'un refuge. Tout issue
this was me about to record and tell you guys what's happening, but then I realized that a man had been following me for like 5 blocks. I love being a woman. I was actually scared to death. Anyways.
Hey guys.
Hello,
We're going to lunch right now. Look at the fits. We're a little coordinated, aren't we?
Let me. Oh, yes, yes.
So now we're going to have lunch. We're going to chill. And then later tonight, we're going to a little party.
Yes.
Keep you posted.
Laissons le monde à ses problèmes, les gens haineux face à eux-mêmes.
I'm not gonna lie, we almost just died. We almost just died. But for some reason,
there was this guy jumping.
Literally,
another guy.
Like, this guy literally just got jumped. We get out of our Uber, get to my Airbnb, and I'm like, fuck, I forgot the code to the front door. Because it was written on my phone, but I didn't have it anymore. Okay guys, we get to our Airbnb. I realize I don't have the passcodes to the fucking front door. And not to mention, we are literally
in the middle.
Like, every person I've told that I'm staying here, they're like, bro, you get Ubers there and back, like, to your front door. Like, this is not good. Right when we realize this, we're at the front door, no codes, no nothing. Like, you know, dressed how we're dressed. Feet away from us is a guy just gets jumped. Appelez la police, appelez la police. This guy walks off, blood on his face. I'm like, oh hell no, oh hell no. We're knocking on the window being like, Q, are you in there? Like, nobody's home. Finally, we asked the boulanger that's like right next to my apartment that we're staying at. And we're like, do you by any chance know anybody that lives in this building or that has the code? Somehow this man has the code to the building. Thank God, and we fucking got in. Like, I actually thought we were gonna die.
Truly.
But we're all good now. We're getting ready to go to the party.
I'm the worst vlogger ever. Jump cut to the next night where I met up with my little basekey here, and we met these two guys that literally bought us drinks the entire night, like non-stop flowing drinks. We got so excessively fucked up and went out to a couple clubs, and it was lit. Yeah.
Hi guys, thank you for watching my vlog. I know this was low-key a really shit vlog because of the whole crisis incident, which just really threw me off. I was really thrown off. I will try to make the next one better, but I hope you guys still enjoyed it. And yeah, this is my new cat, by the way. My little kitten. His name is Lou. He's falling asleep. His name is Lou. I got him right after I came back from Paris. I'm gonna try to do a New York week in the life vlog next. So stay posted for that. And yeah, love you so much. Kisses.